Wherever there is offense, there is also defense. And so there are many sites online that are full of online ads, but there is also something that you can do about it. That thing itself is somewhat controversial. So you can install what's referred to as an ad blocker. So an ad blocker is a piece of software that runs in your browser. Most major browsers that I'm aware of support some form of this, particularly as an add-on. So Chrome has support for ad blocking as an add-on, I'm pretty sure. Firefox does as well. I don't know about other browsers. And what ad blockers do is they examine the content of a page as it's loading, and they try to remove content that they can detect comes from advertising networks. And the way that this is done, I'm sure, is very complicated, but it can also be quite effective. So let me show you an example of this. So I've opened an incognito window in Chrome, and when I do that, it disables all of my extensions. So I have an ad blocker installed, but inside the incognito window, it's not going to be used. So let me go to a site that delivers an advertisement. This is the New York Times, again, and you can see down here that there's this Capital One advertisement that's been loaded as part of the page. So this is what happens when I view the page without an ad blocker installed. Let me open a normal Chrome window and go to the same website. Now I've got my ad blocker running now. And you can see that, let's see, let me go back to over here. It didn't load any top of the page ads this time. A lot of times the New York Times will put ads up here flanking its masthead. In this case, it didn't, but you can see that there's a Capital One ad here. And if I go over to the copy that I loaded in my ad blocker, there is no Capital One ad over here at the top of this sort of newsfeed type feature of the site. So as the site loaded, my ad blocking software detected that there was an ad that was going to be placed here and eliminated that part of the page. And again, the technical details of how this is accomplished, I'm not familiar with. But I think part of it is simply identifying ad networks by their URLs and sort of understanding that certain images and certain content that come from those URLs are going to be used to place ads and then eliminating that part of the page. So you can see that the ad is just gone. That's kind of cool. So these ad blockers work quite well, actually, and it can be very bracing to sort of browse the internet without them when you're used to them. However, sort of recently there's been a bit of a backlash to this. So let's go to a site that has started to sort of aggressively push back against ad blockers. So you can see here, as I load Forbes.com, let me move this over a little bit so this is on the screen. The site has placed an ad here. 4 ways to avoid running out of money during retirement. I guess that's something that Forbes readers are concerned about. Okay, and at some point it takes me to the Forbes site, and there's still this huge ad at the top. Okay, this is kind of terrible, actually. So let me try loading that using my... Now, this is a site that clearly is providing free content, and it's doing that, at least in part, through ad funding. So there's an ad here. Let's see if there's other ads on the page. Let's see, this is, I think, another ad, although it's not looks like an ad. Here's another ad. You know, so there's quite a few advertisements on this page. It's clearly Forbes is relying on ad revenue. Now, if I go to that same site with my ad blocker on, it actually doesn't allow me to continue. It says I have one of two choices. I can whitelist the site using my on my ad blocker, which means that the ads will be allowed on this particular site, or I can log in. And I don't know why this is an option. I suppose that maybe if I log in, they can use Facebook to deliver ads or something like that, or they can track me using some of my Facebook history, or maybe the information that they gather and that they gain from me logging in through Facebook is worth whatever loss they're going to achieve in advertising. And so, let me see here. Yeah, I can't actually even enter the site without doing this. And so this is one example. Now, this is an example of a site that's actually withholding content from me until I turn off my ad blocker. There are other sites that will just complain about it. They'll throw up a pop-up and say, it looks like you have an ad blocker installed. Why don't you contribute or something like this? And so I think this is part of an ongoing conversation between users of the internet and people that provide content. People that browse the internet frequently don't necessarily like online advertisements. A lot of times they're intrusive, they make the pages hard to read, they make the pages load very slowly. turning on an ad blocker can actually make the internet a lot more usable because online advertisements aren't always very well implemented. On the other hand, sites that rely on ad revenue need people to leave these pieces of software unenabled. They need you to not install an ad blocker so they can maintain this revenue stream. And so I think that it's part of an ongoing conversation about how we pay for things online. I hope that we can move past an ad-based model, but this is a sign that at least there's some now growing awareness among people who provide content online that people are turning off ads. And the reason we're doing this is because ads are kind of intrusive. We don't like them. I would appreciate other ways to pay for content and view online, and I'm hoping that we can move in that direction.